Are you all sitting comfortable to square on your body? Then I'll begin.
Soaking something full of colored dreams. Deep inside a rainbow lived happiness man, in a small Victoriana charaban. Evening will be here quite soon. Stan could sit and watch the moon, watching as the white light slowly makes the night bright, while sleeping by while time stands still.
Like all real life experience story, this also begins once a polytito. And Happiness Stan, whose life evolved the ephemeral colour dreamy most, had his pure existence and this being in a deep jaw of the multicolour of the rainbow. Oh yes, his home is a Victoriana Sharabold. This is a four-wheelful olive out the back grove. Now, as Eve done his deep approachy, his eye on the moon. All time, sometime, deep joy of a full moon scintillating dangly in the heavenly bode. But now only half. Oh, blow your cool, man, he do this deep thorkus. What is the folly of this half-disappearing of the moony most? And as the light did a scintillating change through timely most, stop it still, and he did a deep thorkus. What? Absolutely smash and flake it he was. So, gathering all behind in the hintermost, he ploddy forward into the deep thunder mould of the complicated foray to sort this one out, matey. Where at, Mandy Thorkus? Where at, man? Oh, dear.
That I'm gonna find it better.
Now, after a little lapse of time, Stan became deep hungry in his tumload. Oh, after all, he struggly trittly house several mile load, and anyone would suffer under this. So suddenly he did deep thoughtcus, out with his lunchy bag, just about to do a little nib load of his mincy meaty, when... overwhelmed with this deep generosity of Stan's give of the foodage, because all life is stuff of a foodage. He looked at Stan and said, "Is there anything I can reciprocate or do in the joy of return for your generosity for giving me food and stuffy?" "Stan, I'm looking for the other half of the moon and dangly. This is my folly. Show me where the missing half of that moon." "I don't know," said the fly returly, "but I know someone who know. If only I were big enough to transport him most, I'd take it there myself, I would do this." And Stan, having the possessive power of the magic hold, stand it over, roll it up the sleeve, wavely hand, hovery, 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 and utter these magic words, "If all the flies were one fly, what a great, enormous fly philolloper that would bold. Oh, and there, incredible buzz. Oh, dear, hovery, hovery." Now the fly recoiled with these wordage: "Not only will I transport them there, but I'll sing it a deep joy of a song load in your eardroves. That I will do."
Would be yesterday. The sun is surely just a thought away. Where visions that men fail to put to words to tell, and music they try but cannot play. Thank you.
so, seated comfortable on the back of this enormous buzzy most of the flight, whoop, they took it off like an escape velocity of the rocket floating into orbit. Now, after floating high up over the mountain through the deep valley of that for 7 whole long days, they did a very soft and flat belly landing, if I may put it this way. Where they landed, a tranquil beauty spotted before a deep thunder mould of a foray. Like Orpheus in the undergrowth, there it was, and the fly said it, "I must leave you here." And he pointed here with his sort of fly-type thing, gold, if it was all feathery, and said, "Mad John, mark the words. He liveth in a cave there in this far deep foray, and he will transport for you and find it not only the moon itself which you look at, but the philosophy of life to itself." And Stan had a mutual joy for this, and reach up and cuddly most of this big fly, and very hard to embrace it and most and kissing, and the fly tickling with his whiskers in his ear throat. And off he went.
There was an old man that lived in the greenwood. Nobody knew him or what he had done. But mothers would say to their children, "Beware of Mad John." John would sing with the birds in the morning, laugh with the wind in the cold hand of night. But people from behind their curtains said he's not quite right. John had it sussed. He was living the life of a tramp. Yes, his bed was the cold and the damp, but the sun was his friend. He was free. So here was a wise one who loved all the haters. He loved them so much that their hate turned to fear. And shaking from behind their curtains, the loved ones would hear.
So Stan walk it towards the cave, and in his mind, mark your word, Mad John. Deep focus on this, all a-trembloed, looking into the dark and peering into the back grove of black in there. And then appeared Mad John, in fine, fine, foldy silken robes, all whitely hair, scintillating beard and dangling. Well, the beard must have been 34 years old to grow it and grow it all night load. What? And he was glowing with a friendly light, oh dear, joy, and a voice full of a cockney, all joy of life and livid emanate from the cockload of his heartstrings. "Called to see you, man. What's been your hang-up, man? I waiting 7 whole days for you. Not still worried about this since late moon and dangly, huh?" "Stan, yes, that's why I sorting you out here, and trittly how on the back of this fly, who told me?" And John linked arms with him, and walking out stepper by stepper, and he pointed with a cockney forefinger gold, "There, up in the heavenly bode." What? Stan realised now, which it struck him like a smacker o' blurdy, which come now turn he never thought us before. As the sun rises in the early mordy, so the recoil of the moon on the eve. Ah, and he thought. Now, the fly had something extra special you thought us to say to me, if you wold. And John looked at him, and attractness earnestly of his eyeballs, straight nose to nose and eye to eye bolt for it. Of course, I nearly forgot it. Just you listen.
Life is just a bowl of old bread. You wake up every morning and it's there. So live as only you can.
It's all about, enjoy it, 'cause ever since you saw it, there ain't no one can take it away.
So life is just a bowl of old bread.
Very true. What you say has made it very clear.
So be sure, I'll live as best as I can.
But
together, then half the moon is taken away. I've got the benzene, if you can laugh and sing, I give me that happy days toy town newspaper smile. We'll clap twice, lean back, twist for a while. Well, when you're run together and feeling out of tune, I sing this special song with me. Don't worry about the moon, looks after itself.
Sing now.
I give me a happy day's toy town newspaper smile. We'll clap twice, lean back, we'll twist for a while.
Well, now you've got the hang of it, there's nothing you can't do with it.
Well, if you're very true to it, you can't go wrong.
So remember the very special words. Happy day long, toilet town, newspaper reader and chuckly smiler. They all had a lovely turn. Gnomes came, huckleberry pickle tickle my thing gold, but boy blue left his horn stuffing under the settee and brought his mellotrone and freaked them all out. Oh, what a mind blast. Jackie Jill, knees up Mother Brodie, oh, what a joy of a trittly howl there. I hope your turn out is three quarters half as lovely, won't you? Wouldn't half enjoy it. Stay cool, won't you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.